You're listening to the Major Pod Network, the only place where your favorite toy store, bar, arcade, and arena are all on the same block. Scratch that major itch.
Welcome, everyone, to episode 28 of MC True Long Island Story. I am your host, always ready, the internet champion, the GCW world champion, Matt Cardona.
I'm also your producer of the show, Smart Mark Sterling, the man who sold out the United Center on Friday.
Congrats. Congrats.
What's up, Matt? We had a big weekend. Just came back. Also, this show is directed by Pabst Blue Ribbon, so let's crack that. Strawberry basil today.
Speaking of Pabst Blue Ribbon, I defended my GCW world title successfully.
Mm-hmm. I saw a couple clips. I haven't seen the match yet.
First of all, GCW, so fucking Bush League. I'm cutting hell of a promo.
Yeah, maybe they need even to fix their mics.
Maybe even pipe bomb style promo. Yeah. And you can't even hear it if you're streaming it. If you're watching on Fight, you can't even hear it. Right. And the whole match, I'm doing commentary as I'm beating up this fat and you can't even hear it.
Right.
But, however, our friend John Space Carlo has the handheld footage and we'll put it into an upcoming vlog so you'll be able to see everything.
Oh, you vlogged
it. And hear everything. I vlogged it and John Carlo filmed the whole match and promo. So we will put that up. We might even put the promo up as a standalone and then in the vlog.
Nice.
Because it's a shame that nobody could hear it. I plugged Zombie Sailor Heels and Faces, you know. I got a couple of jokes in there and nobody heard it.
Right.
we'll talk more about the whole event on the Major Wrestling Fair podcast. But I did dress up as ECW champ Vince McMahon.
Yep. Yep.
And then I'm looking in the ring and I see there's a major PBR like logo. So I go under the ring to look for a weapon, and what do you know? There just so happens to be a six-pack of PBRs under there.
Well, thanks for Drizzly. What's PBR sent that to you under the ring. That was great.
Yeah. So I used it as a weapon, hit the guy in the head.
That would hurt.
And then took a sip and sprayed it in his face. And then after I won, I stood on top of him. I pinned him with my foot in his chest while holding a PBR. So you can't pay for that type of publicity. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You just can't.
Little enhancement match, I feel.
Well, he put up a fight.
Yeah. Oh, okay. He yeah, you're right. A couple spinning heel kicks.
He put up a fight.
All right. Episode 28 of MC True Long Island Story. Let's get a little bit of some follow-up here. Dark Shadow Zake says, Mark, you forgot to mention that Kevin Nash attacked CM Punk, which leads to the cash-in. We talked about SummerSlam last week. Then the following night on Raw, which we'll talk about today, CM Punk and Kevin Nash have the opening promo segment. Which, by the way, I added a new TV into my office. So on the TV, as we're recording, I am watching the August 22nd or August 20th or whatever it is, Raw from 2011, as we speak. John Cena versus CM Punk tonight on Raw.
Oh, wow. Is that going to distract you while we're doing this?
No. No.
Okay.
Frank E91210. Mark, sorry for the left field question, but could you please talk about being at Rampage during CM Punk's return? Well, it's 2011. I thought this was relevant. 2011, CM Punk's top of the world. We talk about this a lot. He helped you out early on, tweeting your things, and then he's back. He's back.
He's back,
Wrestling
baby.
Broski, did you see him come back?
I did not see it, but I knew it was happening.
Yeah.
Like, you know, so I kept refreshing my Twitter. Because I was in Vegas,
right?
Getting ready for GCW, so I watched his entrance and parts of his promo through Twitter. And man, like, you can't deny that pop, baby,
dude, insane.
The fans have been waiting for a long time to see him, so really, really cool. And then he gave out those ice cream bars.
Finally.
I mean, it wasn't the same type, but it's still. Hey, beggars can't be choosers.
CM Punk ice cream bars.
Did you get one?
I didn't know. We'll talk about the collectability of those ice cream bars. Mm. I have some questions for you guys on the Major Pod, Major Wrestling Figure Podcast.
Okay.
But yes, I will tell you that the pop was insane being there. A lot of people very excited. So good to see wrestling firing on all cylinders all over the place.
Oh, I love it. I have a little follow-up too. Instagram user Mike Kala 98. He said, listening to MC True and the Cafe Patron bit popped me. I remember being at Miller's Ale House for Big O's birthday, and Matt ordered dozens of cafe shots for the group. I wound up, passed out, puking on the bar. Big O had to carry me home. So,
is that your buddy?
No idea.
Oh,
I feel bad. Like, I probably met him that night.
Oh wow!
But I don't know who it is.
That's cool. Well, hey,
and if I know who you are and I don't know who you are, then I feel really bad. Sorry, bud.
Harry Flynn says, this was Swoggle's debut on Z Trolling on a Story. That's last week's episode. We had a little debate on that. And Harry Flynn also says, Zack Ryder's first game appearance was in SmackDown versus Raw 2009, and it came out in 2008, and he was an unlockable character.
Yes, and that was the fattest check I ever got.
Even as an unlockable game. Character.
Yeah, I think everyone, well, I would say everyone, but you know, it was just like being in the game.
Right, for sure. Okay, that's it for me. Anything for you? Follow up?
That was it so far. That was
okay.
It.
Well, let's do the Broski of the Week, but first a little word from our sponsors.
The Major Pod Network has a new tag team partner, Pabst Blue Ribbon.
Everybody needs some liquid courage to make their own weekly purchases. Scratch that figure itch and scratch that PBR itch.
Get your PBR beer, get your PBR hard coffee, and get your PBR stronger seltzer.
8%? If you're listening to this, you're already a major mark. Now it's time to become a major PBR mark.
Use the hashtag MajorPBR and post your pictures and videos of you major marking out.
Pabst Blue Ribbon and the Major Pod Network, the new tag team champions of the world.
Of the world! But we're definitely not getting any new figures from Mattel.
The Broski of the Week.
All right, the Broski of the Week. All you got to do, leave a review on iTunes, Spotify, wherever, screenshot it, then find the pinned tweet on my Twitter, at the Matt Cardona, quote tweet that tweet, post your screenshot, and use the hashtag Broski of the Week. You will win this 8x10 that you could also get on mattcardonamerch.com. You will win the Broski of the Week headband, available on mattcardonamerch.com, and you will win the Broski of the Week sticker, exclusive to the Broski of the Week. So the Broski of the Week this week is, let me pick it up, let me find it. It's somewhere on my phone here. It's at FanLocks. Words cannot describe the impact Zack Ryder has made in my life. First, I've only been a wrestling fan since 2015. I somehow was a fan of Ryder even after the 2011 run. Wow. I remember wanting him to win at Mania 32, and he did. Since then, he was my number one favorite WWE superstar. I since bought all the merch, binged all episodes of ZTLIS twice, and used to check main event spoilers for years, hoping Zack Ryder wasn't on, which meant there was a chance he'd be on Raw. This podcast helped me realize why he has always been my favorite. I see myself in him. I have dreams of being a pro wrestler, and I feel like the underdog in most situations. Funny enough, I collect toys and have a decent following on my Wrestling Fig Fed YouTube channel. Meeting Matt Cardona in Texas last year and plugging my figure channel on the Major Pod Network was a dream come true. I truly got to meet my hero that day. One thing I never got to do, however, was be Broski of the Week. And now this is my chance. You got a Broski for life in me. Thank you for being my biggest inspiration. WWWYKI. Well, Fan Locks, you are the Broski of the Week. Congratulations.
I met a man somewhere who came up to me to tell me that you were his favorite wrestler of all time. I forget where I was. But anyway, similar thing. Great, awesome. Great review. All right, let's talk about tweets. August 21st, Matt Cardona. I saw Heel Ziggler at Tim Hortons today. Is that some sort of joke?
I don't know. I mean, maybe.
Does he not like Tim Hortons? Does he love Tim Hortons?
I might have been riding with him. I don't know.
Got it. Matt Cardona, August 18th. I love that WWE Superstars doesn't premiere on WWE.com on time. August 23rd, congrats to my broski at True Kofi and at Find Evan. I'm not sure what you were congratsing them.
They probably won the tag belts or something. Air boom.
Air boom, baby. Still both doing well today in professional wrestling. I'll tell you that Evan Bourne is one of the nicest people on planet Earth.
Oh, 100%. I would have some great matches with him on live events as a heel. Him being a babyface, of course, like an opening match on a house show is always a great spot to be in because you can kind of like set the stage for the whole show and people are excited to see action. And with Evan Bourne, there was certainly action. And he was so small where I could like, not that I was so much bigger than him, but I could kind of do more powerful things with him.
Sure.
You know?
Catch him in the air and he would be doing his things. Yeah, of course.
And then like, you know, he's such a pro. I don't know how we figured it out. I don't know if I did it on accident or what, but we realized that like for his Shooting Star Press, I can make it seem like I'm trying to get out of the way and he would get me and like slam me back down. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah.
So I'd almost be doing like a reverse push-up, like trying to get out of the way and he would nail me with it.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. He was a total pro. I love working him.
Great dude. And then finally, two more. Matt Cardona, August 23rd. The earthquake on the East Coast was caused by WWE dropping the ball with me. By the way.
Hell of a tweet.
You know, like I've said before, tweet interactions back then in 2011 weren't what they are today. Yeah, I mean, right now you can tweet and get something like 10,000 likes on something or 1,000. You know what I mean? Like, that's a good tweet. This was, by all means, one of your most popular tweets that I've seen since doing this.
Hmm.
But a nice little joke. I think everybody loves it.
Because back then, people weren't saying stuff like that.
Exactly.
Now, oh my God, people complain all the time about their spot and they're not getting put. Like, nobody was I'm not saying it was the right thing to do, but nobody was doing it back then. But this was before my bitter run where I was doing it in a funny way, at least I thought.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Oh, for sure. And I'm sure that blew people's minds.
Yeah.
Just seeing that. And then finally, August 23rd, thanks to my broskies in Edmonton who bought my shirt last night at Raw, it was the most broski shirts sold ever in one night. I'm sure that number just keeps going up and up as 2011 goes on, but pretty cool.
Yeah, certainly. Yeah, pretty absolutely. Cool. It was cool to, you know, start the year not having a real shirt, then getting a shirt. Now it's at venue, which is a big deal because, listen, just because you have a shirt on WWE Shop doesn't mean they're bringing it to the venue.
That's true. Yep.
So it's like a huge deal.
Okay. Matches you had. The show goes up last week at 8 on 8/18/11, and then you fly to Saskatchewan, Canada, and you wrestle at the Brandt Center in Regina on 8/19/11. Zack Ryder defeats Drew McIntyre again. This is the Broski World Title Tour 2011. And then 8/20/11 in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canada, at another house show, Zack Ryder defeats Drew McIntyre again. And then Raw isn't recorded until the 21st, so I'm wondering what you would have done on that Sunday. Probably probably a travel day or something.
That's weird.
But Raw is in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. It's got a 2.97 rating at the Rexall place. So you have a little segment on Raw. R-Truth is out there and unfortunately seems to be taking The Miz with him. The conspiracy theorists attack Santino Marella prior to his bout with Zack Ryder and then proceed to bellyache about how they were heading to the pay-per-view, blah, 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 blah. So they take out your opponent and you do not get to have a match on Raw.
Am I even like in the ring or is it just like a graphic or what?
I have Raw on right now. If it comes up, I will update you. But I
have this weird memory that like I don't even come out.
Oh, probably.
Yeah.
We'll see. I'm almost there. I'm watching Dolph Ziggler in a suit right now and it doesn't really fit him. Over on SmackDown, you are not there and I checked. I skimmed through the entire show. That SmackDown is in Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Teddy Hart could not make it. So Bret Hart is the guest.
Teddy Hart?
I'm sorry. Teddy Long.
Teddy Hart was the general manager.
Teddy Long couldn't make it. Bret Hart is the GM for the night. He does not need an assistant to the GM, so you do not do anything on that show. Mark Henry's doing stuff in that show. He's fighting Sheamus, blah, blah, blah. There's Christian argues with Bret Hart. But over at Raw, it's still Alberto Del Rio is the champion. He's feuding with John Cena and CM Punk. CM Punk versus John Cena in the main event for the number one contender. So that's what's going on in the world of WWE. Interesting that it's John Cena, CM Punk at the top. Christian as well. All these guys still firing on all cylinders today.
Matt Cardona too,
yeah. okay. Episode 28 of Z True Long Island Story. You open the show, no background at all. Blank wall.
Still, I don't know why I cut out that, like, maybe I thought that other background was too cheesy and I was waiting for something better.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I can think of.
On a poster or whatever it is.
Yes.
Sign of the week is a picture of like your hair over glasses. It says woo woo, you know it.
Yeah, because the three W's are like the woo 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 entertainment logo I was using for a while. Like the WWE with the extra W. So yep. I like that.
Great cool. Sign. Also in front of a picture, Triple H is talking to Kevin Nash.
Talking to Big Kev.
That was funny. I think that segment is coming up right now as I watch it. There's Triple H in the ring. You say Raw was in Edmonton, and you met Wayne Broski, and it's a statue. Like
Wayne Gretzky.
Yeah, statue of Wayne Gretzky with Broski stuff on it.
Did I self-popped when I watched this.
Did you do this?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I must have.
I would have been real nervous to do that.
And then we had to cut the shirt like NWO style.
Right.
To get it on. It was topical. It was fun.
Man, I'll tell you this. At the United Center this week, I was nervous to even go close to the Jordan statue and take a picture. You're climbing all over the Gretzky one with your merch. Got some balls on you in 2011. This is a funny segment here. This is Scott Stanford is trying to convince Justin Roberts
this one's good.
change how he says your name. He wants Justin Roberts to say Long Island Ice Z, and he wants him to roll the rider like rider. Justin Roberts plays along. I thought it was pretty funny. Justin Roberts is a big supporter of the show.
Yeah, this isn't Justin's debut. He already debuted on the show, right?
Yeah, I think he's been in the show. Yes.
So this has Justin Roberts and Scott Stanford written all over it.
Right.
So I don't know whose idea it was, but it came across great.
Yeah.
It was really good.
I laughed. I laughed.
And you know, Justin, somebody I rode with for many years. Like, I don't want to say strange. He would do like some weird, like he would, I don't know. Listen, I love Justin. I
okay.
All but right. Like, you know, if we're ordering from like a drive through, he'd be like, excuse me, ma'am. Like he'd always like try to like be extra weird to the, you know, whether it's a waitress or like someone at a drive through, it's like, can you just order the sandwich? You know, do you have a sandwich? Like, well, come on.
He enunciates. He's an announcer. I mean, he's a
But Justin was awesome because, you know, he was a ring announcer, duh. So since he's technically an employee, WWE would give him the car, you know, a car. So we would like squeeze into like a minivan or an SUV and get a free car.
And he was cool with that?
Bro, not only was he cool with it, he like insisted on driving.
Huh.
And then like we would listen to either like Howard Stern the whole time because we'd get like, you know, satellite radio, or we just like listen to like WWF, old WWF themes and shit like that.
That's awesome.
It was cool. It was so great.
One thing I've noticed about Justin Roberts, never nervous. I mean, he's done this a zillion times, but he's out there in front of 15,000 people.
He's a pro's pro.
Yeah.
You know, Justin and I, you know, we would go way back. So we'd always, not just me, Justin, I do this with a lot of my friends too, but we would like sneak photos of each other and then like send them to like a bunch of other people. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
So
like when, your Hacksaw Jim Duggan picture of Brian.
Exactly.
Yeah.
When I took a picture of Brian, who wears the singlet, but the tights were down, so it looked like he was like 93 Hacksaw, Hasbro Hacksaw.
With no hand legs.
So anyway, so we're at Raw in Atlanta, Georgia. We do the show. Justin gets fired. Like, they fire him after the show, right?
Did he do something wrong, or was it just, this is...
It was just his time, right?
Oh, okay.
So they fire him, and when they fire people, they escort you out of the building. So security had to escort him out of the building. Luckily, the show was already over, so we're going to leave anyway. What's Justin going to do, right? So they escort him out of the building. I'm riding with him. So as they're escorting him out, I'm behind just taking pictures.
And like, oh, my God.
And then like he drops me off at the hotel, and as I get out of the car, I send him the picture. But he put it in his book. He put it in his book.
Well, let's plug his book right now because...
Yeah. Because I'm in it. Justin I'm in Roberts. It. And I got a photo credit. I'm a photographer.
I'm Justin Roberts. Let's look up this book on Amazon right now. Justin Roberts, Beat Your Backstage Pass Through My WWE Journey. Beat Seat in the House.
Best.
Best seat in the house.
Beat Seat.
Your backstage pass through
You're
my
taking
WWE
too much
journey.
Blue Chew, Mark.
You can get an audiobook, hardcover, Kindle. Check it out, guys.
Justin's the man. And you know what? I'm so happy for him that he's in AEW because, like you said, he's so good. He's so talented. Mm-hmm. And one thing that I hope happens, and I think he actually has a shot at it now, is that we get a Jazzwares AEW Justin Roberts figure because Mattel wasn't doing it. You know, they don't do ring announcers, but I feel like, you know, AEW's already done Ref Aubrey, right? So why couldn't they do, like, for instance, I don't know, the entrance stage with Justin Roberts or a different ring with Justin Roberts or a build of Justin Roberts. You need the goddamn ring announcer.
Hell yeah.
And Justin deserves a figure, and I hope he gets it. You know, just a super cool dude. And I think, like, a quasi-figure collector, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't think he's as obsessed with it as us, but, you know, he would certainly love to have his own. That's what I'm saying.
Right. Well, that'd be great. I'm with you 100%, and I agree on all the Justin Roberts stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can we put in the picture of when his ass got fired?
Yeah, send it to me right now.
I'll find
not
it.
Not right now, but after. Okay, Broski buys his merch shirt at the merch stand.
This
you
is
ask
legit.
For an extra medium, and you say, "Keep the change, babe."
This is legit. This is in Canada. I legitimately did it. I don't want to say this is the first time it was on sale. Obviously, no, it wasn't the first time it was on sale because we already mentioned it was the best selling. But in Canada, I guess they were using a different printer. So like I consider like a variant shirt cause the hair is a little different colors
Ooh.
To the hair.
Ooh-hoo.
Yeah.
So you just kind of noticed this at some point. You're like, well, I got to go out and get it.
I think I'm just going to go out and get it anyway.
Yep.
And it was kind of like an added bonus that it was the variant.
Speaking of shirts, CM Punk sells a lot of shirts.
Sold number one selling shirt of all time.
In 20
on Pro Wrestling Tees.
Yeah. Insane. Regal's there in a backstage segment again. He's complaining to Jan again.
Talking very low.
Fan
in the background, blowing.
He's mad that he was on your show. It got a lot of hits because he's over. Jan says, over what? That's kinda...
This was legitimate. It got to 100,000 faster than any other episode.
So you tell him that, and he's like, well, of course.
Yeah, and Regal and I would have some inside joke that he was so over. And like a joke that probably started then and lasted until I left WWE. Like every time I'd see him, I'd be like, sir, where's your private dressing room? You know, like, where's the dressing room with the star that says Mr. Regal? Because right. you're so over.
Right.
You know, so it was an inside joke that started off of that, which it was true. He did get to 100,000, you know, faster than anybody.
Right. That was a good episode. We've talked about that.
Yeah.
Broski of the week this week, SoundCloud/CNoEvil, no is N-O, evil.
Great rap.
Does a rap song. Yeah, I enjoyed it. Good job.
Such a great rap. One line that I loved was something about not being with Princess Leia anymore, but he's riding Han Solo. I like that. Get it? Like riding Solo, but riding Han Solo?
Right.
You don't get it, do you?
I'm looking up the... The SoundCloud does not exist anymore. Sorry. So you know evil. Sorry. But thank you for the rap. But great raps.
It was
obviously
awesome.
Watch the show.
That's like I said before, some weeks, Broski of the week, it's like, oh, which one do I have to put up? Some weeks, like, oh, this is the one. You know?
Yep.
This one was great.
100%.
You also skipped over, it was my dad's birthday.
Oh, yeah. Oops.
And it's his birthday today. So, Dad, happy birthday.
I was going to ask that.
65 he turned today.
His action figure sold out.
That's right. His Micro Brawl sold out. So this was like another Morrison bit, which was so ridiculous.
I'm going to let you take this one.
What, Mark?
Well, no, it's just, I want to know who made this cake. So he's there with a cake.
It's a cake with a John Morrison like photo on it. So I don't know if we went to Carvel or like I don't know a grocery store, but you know it's just you can put photos on cakes.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a John Morrison cake. He's blowing out the candles, you know, and then I shove his face into the cake. You know, you think that's it, but he gets up not hot but smiling, and he says, "I have Morrison frosting all over my face."
I don't know how you weren't laughing when he said that. I mean, you only had one shot at this.
So only like, one shot. This is a one-taker.
You're like, Dad, do not mess this up.
And I don't think he got the joke, so he was all for it.
And then you're like, hey, Dad, do you mind if I get this cake? I can smash your face in it. And he's like, sure, buddy. Come on over.
Pretty much, yeah.
What a supportive dad. Pretty funny joke. Okay, this is a big one. Everyone asked about this. Here's the debut of Ask the Heel, which I think becomes a big thing.
Yes.
Dolph Ziggler's there. He answers a question that somebody asked him on Twitter, I guess. He starts responding. The question is, why don't you respond to your fans on Twitter? He starts talking, if it's not a hot chick, I pass right by. If it is really hot, it's probably a fake picture.
Yeah, I don't think it was so much a Q&A. It's more of his, like, this is before his DZ comedy.
Yep.
This was kind of like, I always joke with him that I gave him his big break.
Yep.
You know, because first of all, the Ask the Heel, a spoof of the Brazzers logo. I don't know if you ever picked that up.
I'm now realizing.
but this was like, at the time, this had nothing to do with the show. It was just a way to get somebody else on and give someone else an opportunity because he's funny. He can talk and he wasn't really getting the chance to talk.
Mm-hmm.
So this was kind of like his outlet to do it. And also, you know, help me out. Because it's star power on the show. It's funny, you know, it's good content. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like a win-win for both of us.
And now you said you asked him to do it or he came to
you? I don't recall exactly what happened.
Yeah.
But like I said, it was just a segment that had really nothing to do with the show. But then when we get into our little storyline, we turn it into part of the show.
So somebody asked that, like, was it always planned that you would turn this into an angle, or it was just, separate.
Organic.
Thing, and then it
organic. Into. Yeah, organic.
Got it. All right, now you're in the back. You're seeing the doctor. What's this doctor's name?
Dr. Amon.
Yep. He's checking you out because you said you've been feeling bad, and the doctor says you're suffering from a broken heart. Aww.
Yeah, I think we're still on the Princess Leia situation. So just adding a little joke.
Yep.
Thought it was funny.
Big O is in some sort of bathroom. He kisses twice, and he says two kisses for Kelly.
Just a quick way to, you know, continue a storyline and get him on. Kind of like AEW. There's so many guys on the roster, so they do like the backstage things just to get everyone on.
Yeah, for sure.
Just got to get everyone on, baby.
Hell yeah. Now you close out the show with, this is the WWE. This is Zack Ryder. This is the WWE burying Zack Ryder. Nice one.
It was
so you're
one,
literally
yeah.
getting buried in sand under a pier somewhere on Long Beach, I'm guessing.
Yeah, it's Long Beach. That's right. Under the boardwalk.
Yeah.
I lived in an apartment. Yeah, it was just funny. It was one of those, you know, the this is your brain on drugs kind of commercials that I was doing.
Yeah.
At the time, I was living in an apartment like right on the boardwalk. So,
was it in one of those like big apartment buildings?
Yeah.
Okay. That's cool.
But like, I didn't really have much time because like I was on the road all the time. So like, and then I was editing the show when I was home. So I barely like went to the beach, but to film this, I did.
Yeah. You're just like, oh, you got to get buried in sand. Who buried you in sand?
I don't know. That might be
Chiapetta.
Probably Chiapetta.
Yeah.
Probably Chiapetta.
Dad, come bury me in sand. you do a regular closeout and then there's a secret scene and it's your dad. He's got the cake in the face, and he says, this is the best birthday ever.
Jesus.
All right, nice little episode. But before we finish out the show, let's hear a little word from our sponsors. Back.
Yeah, I thought that was one of the shows where if someone says, what's Z True Long Island Story? That's a perfect one to show them.
Oh, yeah.
I think it really like captures the feeling of the show, the charm of the show. You know, this is what Z True Long Island Story is all about. Now, could every episode be like that? No way. But this was definitely one of them. Like I said before, you always shoot for every episode to be the best, but it's not possible.
I like the ones with a ton of characters.
Yes, this one had a bunch. It was a little longer. This one was a little longer.
Yeah, 6 minutes, yeah.
But it didn't, to me, it didn't feel long. And I haven't watched this episode since before episode 100,
right.
You know?
Yeah.
So it's like 9 years, 10 years.
All right, I saw a bunch of good Are You Serious Bros on Twitter.
Are you serious, bro?
Hit me.
Okay. Are you serious, bro? All you got to do is tweet me something, use the hashtag AreYouSeriousBro, and I will send you an 8x10 if it pops me. This one comes from D. Hollow Costo. The 12-foot-tall Home Depot skeleton is the Major of Pod heavyweight champion. Hashtag AreYouSeriousBro. You see that? That giant skeleton wearing the title with the two little kids underneath?
Yes.
I thought that was fun. So.
Phenomenal. Yes, yeah. I sent you that picture because it was unreal.
So you know what? I'm going to send 3 8x10s to them.
Oh, hell yeah.
So they can all have them. Good How job. About that? How about that?
Okay, know your bro. This one's sort of related. I think pretty funny and also a pretty good idea. Shehzad Lakhani at Shehzad says, hey, Matt Cardona, was there ever any talk of Scott Stanford, he tags him too, becoming your manager / advocate on screen, hashtag know your bro. Stanford responds and says, we are still in negotiation. I responded, said, I can help with that.
Right.
But
no, the answer to that is no.
He was like putting you over so good. Like it is kind of, if you were a heel, it kind of works.
Like it was great, like but we were, sure like I've said before, we were both so under the radar.
Yes.
Nobody was like watching Superstars. He wasn't on Raw. Yeah. Nobody was watching my show at this point, so nobody even knew there was a connection.
Right, for sure.
And no offense to Scott, but at this point in my career, I'm worried about getting myself on TV, not Scott Stanford.
Yeah, yeah.
But I would have loved it. It would have been great. I don't necessarily think it would have worked because I'm trying to be a babyface now.
Oh, that's what I'm saying. It would have needed to be a heel thing.
As a heel, for sure. But Scott, super talented, always wanted more, always hardworking, always had ideas. It would have been cool. Still working.
Yeah.
He's the man. We got to have him on one of these weeks.
Yeah. Okay. Characters debuted: Justin Roberts, Dolph Ziggler, Dr. Amon.
I don't think Justin Roberts debuted there.
Oh yeah. Oh yes. I'm gonna check on my chart. I update the chart all the time.
I feel like he debuted on the episode where it's the Ultimate Broski versus the Ultimate Warrior.
You're right. He popped in. Returning dad, Stanford Big O.
And Regal.
This episode, 209,799. It is 604, one of the longer episodes. But like you said, it really flowed quickly. Did not feel long.
Yeah, because none of the actual segments were long.
Yes,
you know?
Exactly. Yeah. And that rap song was just like, I could have listened to that for 4 minutes.
Yeah.
I'm watching right now. Air Boom wins the tag team title. So that's
what
you're
saying. Oh, there you go. Boom,
they look great. They haven't born. Still going strong. All right. That's it for me. I am wearing today the Pro Wrestling Tees exclusive crate shirt of the Major Wrestling Figure podcast of you and Brian as Back to the Future, which is a movie that Brian has never seen.
That is one of my favorite t-shirts. That is in the Pro Wrestling Crate, or was in the Pro Wrestling Crate. But this month in Pro Wrestling Crate, there's another exclusive Major Pod shirt. I probably shouldn't spoil it here, but I'm going to. I don't care. It's the cover to Adventures in Babysitting, if you've ever seen that. And we're all on it. Mark, you're on it. Swoggle, myself, and Brian. And I know Mark is now Googling Adventures in Babysitting.
Oh, my God. Yes. Which one am I? Am I the lady?
No, that's probably me because she's the boss and I'm the boss.
Okay. All right, so I'm hanging there probably. Swoggle's hanging on your shoulders?
Swoggle's the kid, the little girl.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, I like that. That's great. Well, hell of a shirt. Okay, I'm in.
Hell of a shirt, hell of a shirt.
Let's plug that real quick. Major Wrestling Figure Podcast, 3-year anniversary today as we record this.
That's right. Happy anniversary, Mark.
Yeah, man. Hell of a journey. Really enjoyed my life and time with the podcast over the last 3 years. So we're still going strong. Still trying to get Broski's levels good, but we are producing, we are creating content. We appreciate everybody who supports us here.
Yeah, I mean, without the Major Wrestling Podcast, there'd be no Major Pod Network, so there'd be no MC True Long Island Story. You know
exactly.
what I'm saying?
Exactly. So. Yeah. So we appreciate that. But that is, prowrestlingtees.com/majorwfpod. That's where you find our shirts. prowrestlingtees.com/martmarksterling. prowrestlingtees.com/mattcardona. A lot of cool stuff. mattcardonamerch.com.
That's right.
For some cool stuff. And majorpodmerch.com. We just put up the live stuff, sold out like in a couple minutes.
Yeah, that stuff's gone. Live 9, we had a great show at Kowloon. We'll talk more about it on the Major Wrestling Podcast. It was great because there were some Z True Long Island Story connections, if you will. Like we had, where's Trent? Well, we found him. He was there.
Yep.
We didn't even ask him about that.
You're right.
Yeah, where's Trent was there, and John Cena Senior was there. Pop of the night, John Cena's dad. No,
okay,
no. John Cena's dad was awesome.
Did John Cena see his dad's pop?
Yes, he did.
In the video, did he like that?
He did.
A fan of it. Okay, cool.
He did. It was a great show. We had Enzo was there. Francine was there, Eddie Edwards was there, and all you Major Marks were there. It was a lot of fun.
Mark Malibu was there.
Yeah. Andy from Kowloon was there. but Kowloon is, I spent many a night at that red roof next to Kowloon. And it always feels great going back.
You almost
there.
Spent two extra nights at the red roof in Kowloon.
Well, there wasn't a hurricane coming through. You didn't have to stand back.
No. All right. Well, take us out, buddy.
Well, guys, Facebook situation. Jesus Christ. Hopefully by the end of this podcast, we'll have it figured out. But like me on Facebook. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Instagram. Hey, guys, go back and watch all these episodes. Subscribe to this podcast. Subscribe to the Major Pod Network YouTube channel. And buy all the merch. ProWrestlingTees.com. MacaronaMerch.com, and take care. Swig some PBR and spike your hair.
Justin!